Over the years, BioWare's become a shell of the company they once were. They created amazing games like Knights of the Old Republic, Mass Effect, Dragon Age, but they've faced massive problems with developers. They've lost lead after lead on projects, and now they're facing another disaster by losing their fourth major Dragon Age developer. I have a couple of different things that I want to show off, but before we get into the topic at hand, if you enjoy the content that I create, please make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. Follow me on social media like Twitter or mine so that you can see when my content is posted. And if you do really enjoy the videos and the live streams that I create, please consider becoming a Dark Titan via Patreon for just $1 a month or supporting via YouTube memberships. All of the links are in the description, and of course, I do really appreciate all of the support. So I wanted to start off with this Bounding Into Comics article. It says, BioWare loses fourth major Dragon Age dev as series senior creative director exits studio. I've been really looking forward to the next Dragon Age title. I'm a huge fan of the franchise, but unfortunately, it seems like we're not going to be getting this game anytime soon. Year after year, we've heard small little details. We've seen teasers for it at E3. But unfortunately, they just cannot hold on to developers for this project. It says, adding to the already numerous issues facing the series' long-awaited fourth entry, longtime Dragon Age senior creative director Matt Goldman has left BioWare effective immediately, becoming the fourth major Dragon Age-related dev to leave the studio amidst the game's development. So this was the email sent to staff by BioWare Studios GM Gary McKay. It says, "Hi everyone, I hope you're all well, and I'm writing to inform you all that Matt Goldman is leaving BioWare. We have mutually agreed to part ways, and his last day is today. We understand that Matt's departure has an impact on you, as well as the game's development, but rest assured, our commitment to a high-quality Dragon Age game has not wavered, and we will not ship a game that is not up to BioWare's standards. We, including EA's executive team, have absolute confidence in the leadership here at the studio and the people working on the game to carry forward our vision." Now, usually when someone who's been with the company for a very long time leaves, there's a lot of detail in these types of statements. It's usually, you know, we appreciate all the years of work, they highlight the work that they've done, and Matt Goldman's been with BioWare since 1998. I mean, he worked on Baldur's Gate, he's worked on a lot of their major titles, yet in this statement there's no appreciation, and usually we see that, which is a little bit suspicious. This statement comes off as very cold, very brief, very, you know, we've agreed to part ways and today's his last day, so basically don't talk about him. This is the end. He's not at the company anymore. Now, I get it. People come and go from projects all the time, but these people are the glue to the projects. They're the ones who tell everyone what to do, the timelines they need to follow, the people making sure the project comes together and becomes a really good experience for players. And with maybe one change in leadership, projects can get through that, but multiple high-level departures, at least in my opinion, says no one wants to be responsible for the state that the game's in. No one wants their name to be the front and center on the game. People have been waiting years for the new Dragon Age game, and we're all hoping it's going to be amazing and fantastic, but it sounds like it's in development hell right now. There's been a lot of departures over the years. So going back to the initial article, it does point out the history of developers leaving this company. It says, as noted above, Goldman's departure marks the fourth such loss. It says in 2019, then Dragon Age lead producer Fernando Melo left BioWare after 12 years of serving in various roles at the once beloved studio. A year later in 2020, now former Dragon Age heads Casey Hudson, the studio's GM, and Mark Dara, the series' longtime executive producer, left their positions after 20 years of respective employment. We're not talking about people that were there for a year or two that didn't understand the company. We're talking about people who have been the glue to projects in the past, people that are the most notable at the company, developers that have been there for 12 years, 15 years, 20 years. This is kind of crazy to think about. Yes, people come and go all of the time. You know, they might be moved to different projects sometimes as well. But we're talking about multiple leads on this project leaving, and it's got a lot of fans worried about it. As you all know, though, BioWare and EA are in flames right now. EA has game after game released with their names attached to it, and they turn out to be nightmares. Battlefront 2 was a nightmare, Battlefield 2042 is a disaster, Mass Effect Andromeda, Anthem, all of these games have faced massive problems, and look at how much people hate these companies now. They've ruined their good reputations with consumers, and it would take a lot to gain that popularity back, and I honestly don't know if they can at this point. I used to love BioWare. They have created some amazing games in the past, and I've given EA multiple chances over the years, but unfortunately, they're not doing things that people want. They're not releasing games. If they release games, they're in terrible states. They've got tons of problems. It's just disaster after disaster with these companies. And unfortunately now, if you're a fan of Dragon Age, there's more to be worried about because another lead developer on this project is leaving. Now, I also wanted to show off this article from 2019 talking about BioWare departures. It says Anthem lead producer Ben Irving was first announcing on August 15th that he'd accepted an exciting opportunity at another studio. We really haven't seen anything come from this. There's been no announcements with his name on it, but I guess maybe in the future we'll see something. It says, after 8 amazing years at BioWare, I have made the decision to move on. Since the first time I played Baldur's Gate many, many years ago, BioWare was a dream place I always wanted to work. I will be forever grateful to all the people who gave me the chance to work on great products with amazing people. I believe Anthem has a bright future. We see where that went. And there's a great team working on it, and I look forward to following its progress and playing it from the sidelines. Well, Anthem's been a disaster since launch, and I don't really think anyone plays Anthem anymore. But besides that, you can see the difference in statements here. If you look at this statement, he's saying, you know, it was amazing to work here. I really loved working here. I love the people, the games, the product. But unfortunately, if we look at news statements with someone like Matt Goldman leaving, there's no warm statements here. There's no heartfelt statements of appreciation. It's very cold, straight to the point. And a lot of people believe that Matt Goldman had an issue at the company and they just decided to fire him quietly and not make a big scene out of it, but we don't really know. There's been no information like that. It says Irving's announcement was quickly followed by a similar announcement from Fernando Melo, who I just mentioned a few minutes ago, who had been a senior producer on the upcoming Dragon Age title, codenamed Morrison. Now we know it's Dragon Age 4. But it says, today was my last day at BioWare. After 12 years, that's a heck of a lot of feels. Tonight I got to write my name at our local pub alongside many other amazing peers over the years, and it reminded me a lot of folk no longer here that I miss dearly. There's really no easy way to sum up all the fantastic experiences and friendships across our studios, our partners, and in our community that I've been so fortunate to have been a part of over these years. He shared pictures, and he was, again, being really loving towards the studio, saying, you know, I had great opportunities there. I love the people, love the work, but unfortunately, it's just time for me to move on. And it says he had a long history with Dragon Age at BioWare, having served as a senior producer on Origins and Dragon Age 2 before he moved into the role of director of online development back in 2011. Back in 2015, he switched franchises to assist with the online component of Andromeda, but then he came back to Dragon Age to help with 4. We're just seeing departure after departure. Over the years, we've seen many departures, and a lot of people are really worried over the state of Dragon Age 4, and I completely understand that. When we see massive names at a company just decide to up and leave and they decide to part ways, it's really worrying, and I feel like this game's in a bit of development hell. We don't really know. We haven't, you know, seen any leaks or seen any information on it, but I'm definitely gonna be keeping my eye on the situation. But that's all that I really had to discuss in this video. Let everyone know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to give it a like, share it, and subscribe to the channel. And of course, if you didn't, make sure to give it a dislike. I appreciate your support either way, but I will talk to you all again in the next video really soon.